Hello, welcome back to Bournemouth RC. Now, as you can see, my whole Creighton is a part of the back here. That is part of my new Crahave build. So you'll see that as we go along. Part one's out there, which was the strip down and showing you the parts I've got. So I'm going for a Crahave, so the Creighton parts with the Mojave chassis, make it a little bit longer, a little bit more space there for a nice bigger motor. And I've gone for the 8S. Motor out of the Arrma Creighton 8S. So that's what all the parts are around the background. I'm in the middle of building that, but what I'm doing actually is, as you've seen, I've got a new outcast to the channel. So what I've been doing is setting up the outcast before I go and bash it hard. I have already done the shims inside there and changed the weight. This is the front. I've put 60,000 CST oil in there. So that's all ready to go, feels a lot better. So now what I'm actually going to do, which I'll be doing to all my other diffs as well, is I'm going to be shimming this pinion into this housing. Now you've already seen, or if you haven't, check out one of my videos, I'll put a link in the description, me shimming behind the bearing here with these shims to push that gear into the pinion more. But what I've actually come across, and again, a massive shout out to Martin on this one, because he ran me through how to do this. Because when you've got that inside there, in between the pinion, which is going through here, and the housing of the diff, is about 0.6, 0.7 mil. Now, what we're going to try and do is take up that, just so it's about 0.3, 2, 0.3 mil, because actually inside this diff, and I'll get in nice and close to show you, you can actually see the movement of there. So what I'm going to do is get in nice and close to show you and then show you how to sort that out. So now we're in nice and close. If I push that diff right inside that housing, down inside there, hopefully you can see that on the camera. I will try and get it up nice and close. It might just take a few seconds to focus. There we go, now it's focused. You can see that pinion move back and forth in there. Now, as I said, with the feeler gauges, hold that diff nice and tight, and there is about 0.6 of a gap there. So, pop the diff out, pop the pinion out, and pop out the bearing from behind. There we go. So what I've got here is some 13 by 19 washers. I will put a little link in the description of how to find these. These are 0.2 millimeters thick, so I want to take up about 0.4, so I'm actually going to be putting two of these in because I know the gap is between sort of 0.6 and 0.7. I still want a small amount of gap there because I don't want it to rub onto the housing. So, two of these shims in behind the bearing. They drop quite nicely in there. They're perfect size. Then your bearing in. Then your pinion in. And then your diff. Okay, so now, as you can see, let's wait for this to focus again. The bearing is slightly out from the housing, and the movement has been totally reduced on that pinion. So if I try and pull that in and out, it's not going very far at all. What I will just do is with a feeler gauge, I will make sure that there is some clearance through there, which there is. So that's 0.1. So I have, yeah, that's nice and tight there, just about 0.2 of a mil clearance between the pinion and the actual diff housing. So now all I'm going to do is chuck all this back together. This is going to go in the front of my outcast. I've already shimmed and oiled the rear one. I've just got to actually put that into the housing. So I'll be doing the same. And there, now that pinion and that crown wheel are dead in line. It's using the whole of the pinion, not just the end. This should make this a hell of a lot stronger. And the reason why I've been looking into this, obviously, when I go ATES on the Quahave, I want to make these as strong as possible. Inside there, I have put four extra shims, one on each gear. Now, some people put two, some people put four. It does depend on your gears inside there. Don't just put what everybody else puts, because everybody's gears are slightly different. So I've got four in this one. My Creighton has got four in the front, four in the rear, but only two in the middle because that was a lot tighter. So don't just assume something and put in there. So I'm really happy with how this is running now. I'll bolt all this back together, get this up, and get this into the outcast. Okay, that's it from Bournemouth RC tonight. If you like the videos, please hit subscribe. If you want to see some more, obviously coming up is the other parts for the Quahave build. So please subscribe to the channel if you want to see them. Thank you very much and good night.